And I'm going to hijack this opportunity to say, not only are we going to learn from one of our newest amazing partners and friends and global leaders and someone that I'm excited to, but I'm also going to crash this party and say, today is my 4-year anniversary at EXP. Today, officially 4 years ago, I sold my franchise and I took a huge leap of faith. And here I am 4 years later, guess what? With my favorite people and the people that I get excited to every single day to lead with, grow with, be inspired by. All of you guys inspire me. And, it feels like day one. It feels like the same energy from when I was excited about joining. I wake up every single day excited to see you guys, learn from you guys. You guys breathe life into me. And I hope that we can find that within each other. But I just wanted to hijack the call and let you guys know today is my anniversary at EXP, my EXP-versary. So love you guys.
Amazing, amazing.
And if you guys, ever feel like, oh my God, like, is this possible? There's so much possible at this company. And I want to share that because we have new leaders that are joining every single day. And, a lot of people think, oh, we've been here forever. We were the first ones who joined like 4 years ago. The company wasn't even, it was 10 years old already. It was a decade old. And I feel like we're just getting started. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. I'm pumped. I'm excited. It's a great day for me because I get to reminisce on the last 4 years and reflect on everything that has been accomplished together. And I think
that's- Let me add a little bit to that because obviously, as you guys know, I don't have to say this, but the blessing that Veronica has been for this company, not just for the organization, but for the company as a whole, the amount of value she brought from helping us with the growth, with employees, with the strategic alignment behind the scenes, like she does it all. And many of us and many of our partners right here on this call, wouldn't be here if not for Veronica saying yes, right? So this is a great, great, great day to celebrate that she said yes to us. She said yes to this little company when a lot of people were saying no. And now we're massive big companies with big names like her. Which she, when Veronica joined, everybody turned around and said, whoa, I got to look at this thing. What's going on? And even people that are not in this organization paid attention because she joined. So that's a big deal. And it's just a blessing. And thank you so much, Veronica, for saying yes.
Well, thank you for Carlos being the person that was brave enough to invite me to the opportunity. Being a friend, being someone who believed in me as well. And what I also want to share is you just never know who you can bless with this opportunity. And Carlos in his mind would always say, I'm just a small little team and half the team is my family. And he would joke around with that. But Carlos had big dreams and wanted to be, he had a big vision and he wanted to be in alignment with certain people. And he saw me as maybe one of those people he wanted to invite to the opportunity. And I'm forever grateful that you did so. And I hope that this can inspire you guys. If you have someone that you just, maybe you're inspired by, or you aspire to be in business with, or you respect their work ethics, or you respect what they do, like maybe you just be a friend to them. Maybe call them, maybe just explore what the possibilities of growth looks like, and don't say no for them. And I'm glad that Carlos never gave up. He never saw himself as an underdog. He never, and by then I had already known. I was doing my own research, guys, on EXP, and I already was going to come to the company, but I just didn't know how, when, who, what, why. It just was a matter of time. And between him, Rosemary, and everyone else who played a big part of our decision, I chose people. And I will tell you this, if I look back and I look at the 4 years that I've been here, there's no other group I'd rather be in alignment with, no other family I'd rather learn with, no other community of humble servant leaders. And I've always told Carlos, if I go to war with anybody, it'd be with you guys. You guys are the type of people I wanna win with, and I wanna go to war with, and I wanna learn with, and I wanna grow with. So I just wanna kick off this call today with just nothing but gratitude and love, and also welcoming our new leaders who I know are gonna continue to pave the way. And if you haven't gotten ignited yet, or if you feel like you haven't had traction, my first 6 months at EXP, I was just like, head down. I don't know enough about the model. I don't know enough about this. I just want to sell houses. I just want to. And they were like, girl, like, you can, you know, like, you're a leader. We need you to show up. And I was like, you know, who's going to follow me? And all of a sudden I woke up one day. I said, I have a responsibility and a duty. And so if you haven't woke up yet, I'm here to tell you, some people it takes 6 months. Some people come in with guns blazing. Others, it takes a year for them to recognize that they're a leader. Whatever time it takes, today's a new day. And I hope that I could provoke a little bit, just a little bit of fire in you, that what I've accomplished in this company together with some other leaders, you have the same opportunity. I'm proud to show, I did the rankings, Carlos, you rank, and myself and Gil and you know, so many other of us who rank in the top 50 in the company in growth, but also in production leadership and so many more. And we want to lead the way, guys. So let's get loud. Let's get proud. Let's get united more than ever. But right now is about our dear guest, our newest partner, and also one of our amazing leaders who has been paving the way. Recently, his growth has been phenomenal. The amount of leaders that he's attracting is inspiring. And I will say, Eli Torres, you have become my brother. And, you know, we've had our own history of, you know, just growth together and learning from each other. And here you are just taking the industry by charge and aligning so many great leaders. So I want to, first of all, highlight you and just say thank you, brother, for everything you do. And I know you're coming up on 2 years at EXP, or a year and a half. And you have been able to really just inspire some really impressive people to join this opportunity with us, not only in their leadership, but whether it's the impact they want to make in the industry production wise, and also what I believe improving the industry professionalism and raising the bar, not just in Houston, Florida, but also Puerto Rico, which you play a big, big part in how Puerto Rico continues to evolve. So first of all, my friend, I want to congratulate you. And also, if you guys didn't know, Eli is the number one team on the island as well, leads the number, and is the most referred agent in the planet Earth of social media when it comes to an agent on the island, is building a team out there, has a team in Houston as well, and just continues to inspire agents and leaders across the nation and now globally. And in addition to that, he has used his voice to help pioneer change in the company. So first of all, I just want to thank you for all that you do. And then co-introduce to you who we have here, but I'll let you kind of do that on your own for now.
Well, that was huge. Thank you so much, Vero. And I'm so glad that you came to EXP and finally got me over. But John, my friend, broker in Puerto Rico. I don't know how to do a formal intro, but I'll introduce him the way I know John Morales. So John Morales is a Navy veteran. I think 12 years he served, and spent a long time living in a submarine, which is pretty cool. So that alone, I think, teaches you so much discipline that I think it's helping him along in the industry. In the industry, John is a broker in Puerto Rico. And one of the biggest things I admire about John is the fact that he is literally paving the way, and we have very similar mindset. In Puerto Rico, there's not a lot of the mindset of collaboration and cooperating with other agents is not part of the culture yet. And John is one of those people that is just breaking that mold and using his channel and his influence in YouTube to really bridge that gap. I mean, this is the only person that I know in Puerto Rico that's giving a voice, giving a platform to his competition. Right. He's not just there interviewing his clients. He's not just there interviewing lenders. He's bringing on competition. And I mean, big, big dogs in the industry. So I just admire that. I think he's breaking the mold. I think he's starting to get messages from other people like, dude, what are you doing? Like, why are you giving a platform? Why are you, endorsing your competition? And it's that mindset of what's the word I'm looking for? when you think big, there's a word, but anyway, I can't think.
Abundance.
Abundance, yeah, the opposite of scarcity. This abundance mindset, he wants to help the industry. He wants to help Puerto Rico. He wants to bridge the gap between everybody so everybody collaborates. So something I really admire about him, and he's grown his YouTube channel to like over 5,000 followers in like, I don't know, it seems to me overnight, but I'll let him kind of speak on that. But that's who, to me, John Morales is.
Yes, and I want to echo that, like what he's been able to accomplish in 2 short years also is one of the number one HUD brokers on the island as well, representing, you know, the island where, you know, again, HUD homes requires a level of professionalism and efficiencies, and he's doing it in his short, you know, tenure as an agent, not only landing that account, representing at a high level, building his YouTube presence, becoming a reputable agent on the island and off the island as a respected, trusted leader is a big, big task. It's a big accomplishment. So John is here today. John is here today to share with you guys how he built his YouTube channel and how he runs his business. And hopefully, if you've been thinking about it, just to execute, so many times we think it's so hard or it's too late or I'm late to the party. I think John is going to give you guys the inspiration that you need to say it's never too late. You decide to get started. You do the things that are going to move the needle in your business. And this guy was determined. And here we are today, honored to have him as our partner. And he made the big screen at EXP Shareholders. I don't know how he did this. He signs up. He takes a flight. I said, if you're going to join EXP, you're going to come all in. You're going to jump in 2 feet all the way in. And he did. He did not hesitate. And next thing you know, his name and his face is on the big screen. So, John, I hope you felt the warm welcome and the love from EXP. We're going to let you get started so you can bring value into our partners. Oh, you're muted.
There you go. Well, thank you so much. Congratulations, Veronica, on your anniversary. And I'm really humbled to be here. As you guys know, it's only been about 3 weeks since I joined, but I'm ready, you know, to start, you know, providing some value, which is something that really attracted me to this group specifically in EXP. It's that fact that everybody's sharing value, right? Collaborating and making sure everybody else is growing. So I'm glad I'm having this opportunity right away to reciprocate, you know, some of that Eli and Veronica have provided to me. So thank you so much. I will try to make this as interactive as possible. I think my story doesn't have anything that is, you know, out of the norm, anything extraordinary. It's just these small little consistent steps that everybody can take to make, you know, to find their way using YouTube to gain more listings, gain more exposure, establish themselves as a leader and authority in their markets. And there's so much opportunity. I just want to debunk that myth today that maybe YouTube is crowded, that it doesn't work. So I want to debunk that and make sure everybody take something with them. At the end, I will also provide some resources that will help you, you know, after this training to continue looking into this information and evaluating the possibility of, you know, starting your YouTube channel and start attracting leads from that lead source. All right. So just a little bit about myself. Got my license about 2 years ago. Got the, like Veronica said, got a HUD account about 6 months after that. And that's been a lot of work. I will tell you, it is a lot of work. It's busy work, but it has allowed me to take a lot of at-bats and, you know, continue to grow as an agent and in this industry. I'm always focused on improving. I come from a background from nuclear engineering on a submarine and then pharmaceutical engineering, which is highly regulated. You're always looking for ways to make everything better. And that's the exact same thing I've been trying to apply on my day to day as an agent. And now on my YouTube channel, we'll talk about that and how you can do that too. And I'll tell you, there's a lot of like words and phrases that you'll hear on these types of training that I want to just get out of the way, because this is not going to be a motivational talk. It's going to be more practical, right? And a lot of times you will hear things like, you don't have to be great to start. You have to be, you know, you just have to be to start to be great or to get great, become great. Yes, that's true, but there's a lot of work involved, and I don't want to make it seem like just by starting, you will have the results. You will hear a lot, just hit record. I'll tell you there's a little bit more than that, but that's a good start. I also hear a lot, you know, just be like Nike, just do it, right? So hopefully today this is not going to be, you know, 40 minutes or whatever amount of time we're here, just hearing buzzwords and phrases. So I want to get that out of the way. That's not a lot you're going to hear today. And we will talk about. So what I wanted to do is just talk about my journey with YouTube really quick. And then if we want to jump right away into Q&A, because what I want to do is I will take you to YouTube. I will share my screen. I will take you to other tools that I use. I want to navigate and have you ask questions and see it real life and not just, you know, listen to something today and have to go do your research. So so I started filming YouTube on January 2022, so just over a year. And I went all in on it. I film about a video per day for five days a week. And I edited everything with no editing skills. I just had to learn right away. And I got burnt out within 8 weeks. I was completely burnt out and I stopped making videos for 2 months. We will talk about, right, how to do it smart so that way you're not just have this quick peak and then nobody hears from you ever again. How you can do that, how I did it. So what I did after those 2 months, I kind of took a step back and found which were the pain points of my content creation. And one of them, there was two. One was the volume, the amount of videos I was doing. And the second one was absolutely the work that it takes to edit these videos. So I hired an editor as a VA. It's very reasonable, the pricing. And that allowed me to focus on the content creation itself. And then the volume, what we did was reduce it down to 1 to 2 videos per week. And as we improve and we streamline our processes, then we increase the frequency or the quality or amount of videos that we were doing. After that, I hired the editor in April. We started doing content. Then I got this great idea of doing this very complex type of content where I would go visit Airbnbs every week and we'll interview the owners and we also highlight the homes. And for this, what I did, I needed somebody to go with me, film, and it was just not just me with the camera, which we'll talk about equipment as well. And what I did, I found somebody who was willing to kind of do like, he will work just for a small fee in exchange for learning or my mentoring on real estate and investments. And that's how we did it. And the reason I wanted to highlight this, you know, this timeline is because at one point I thought it was everything about views and subscribers and I was getting very frustrated. And I specifically remember the day when I said, you know, maybe this is not the way for me to go with video and doing all this work. I'm not seeing the results because I was measuring results by views and subscribers. And after I went to one of these Airbnbs, and I walked out of there, I remember they made a huge investment on their Airbnb. It's pretty much a hotel. It has like about 11 units on it. And when I walked out of that, I realized that this was more about collaborating and connecting with people that will eventually, very likely, turn out into a business. Not right away. It was not about that view of those subscribers. It was more about how I was going to get those leads to convert them. And I will say that as of last week, that same couple sat down with me for 3 hours and we will be listing that Airbnb for about $6 million. So the results are there. It can happen. And this is just one of, yes, the biggest, obviously, of the other leads that I've created, but it does work. So I just wanted to open with that, just to let you know that it's not about the views and the subscribers. Let's focus right on the conversion. So I will pass it on to Eli, if you want to moderate the questions or do the Q&A, and we'll go from there.
That's huge, man. A $6 million lead, holy moly, from one video. I do want to, I have a bunch of questions, but I do want to ask you one personal one. why YouTube versus like other social media platforms? Not to say that you don't do stuff on other ones, but why YouTube as your main focus?
So the reason was that I knew from YouTube I could create longer form content, which is a little bit more of my style. And from there, I knew that those videos will reside there forever and become that evergreen content. And some of my best videos are years, you know, videos that have been there for over a year, and they just keep getting views and we keep getting leads from. So I think YouTube helped me with that. And I don't have to be, you know, creating constant short videos, but I can create one long video in that week and get 3-4 reels from there. So, you know, I can leverage that video as well.
Beautiful. I like that. So breaking into reels, evergreen content, and you get to break it into reels. And there's a lot of software now that you can actually use for taking that long form video and breaking it into reels using AI. Do you have any suggestions on those softwares? Is there anyone specific you use?
Not for the cutting them themselves. I don't use the AI. I do use it for captions. There's a lot of AI software that do automated captions as well. And there's other AI tools that I'll share with you today here, sharing the screen, that helps you with everything related to your YouTube channel per se.
Beautiful. If you guys want to drop the questions in the chat too, we can ask those questions. Why do you think the video of 100,000 views got way more views than the other videos? What was the technique or focus?
So that video that got 100,000 views, I think and this is something we continually are evaluating. So with YouTube, what you will see is a lot of people will create the video first, and then they'll come up with the thumbnails and the description. So we kind of like start to switch that, where we are coming up with ideas for the videos. And so once we know that idea that we want to implement, we will brainstorm on the thumbnail first. And then we will also brainstorm on the description and how do we want to do the composition of that video. What things are we going to include? So this video had a lot of hype to some extent, because we had created this season of kind of like a small show where we did 10 videos of YouTube Airbnbs, where we go visit these Airbnbs and interview everybody or the owners. And what happened was that did really well. And we about 4 weeks before we started hyping it up in the social media. You know, the second season is coming up, and we'll do a lot of previews. And we did this one a little very different than the other ones, where we did an intro with a voiceover that we hadn't done before. So it just had a lot of attention before it got out. And then once we got out, we had a different thumbnail on that one, where it was just the house on the hacienda that was shown on the thumbnail, and it didn't move all that much. Once we switched it to that kind of like stable, and then used Los Pablos only, because, you know, if you look at like SEO, maybe somebody's looking for Pablo Escobar may also find this video, which I think it helped a lot. So keeping it that simple, for some reason, it just, you know, and the thing with YouTube is you're never going to know exactly which one's that video that is going to go. Because if you look at the screen right now, the one right next to it that has 34,000 views, that the first one, the one on the left, it was all like, you'll see like a peak and it comes down. The second one, that has been very steady, getting about 200 views a week for a year. Mm. And just keeps getting views. So you're never gonna know which one is the video that's gonna cut up.
And John, I wanna kind of emphasize something that I had the pleasure of speaking with you and kind of spending some time with you in, you know, what, maybe like 2-3 hours. We just got to talk. Airbnb is authentic and something that you relate to, because you also are an Airbnb super host and you actually have a property that has become viral and kind of famous. And for anyone who's looking at his page, you know, the fact that if you notice how much Airbnb content he has, it's because this is something that he believes in, that he knows, that he's familiar with, which as you are growing your content, again, what I have found in those who have kind of mastered YouTube and kind of went all in, they're pretty consistent on what their, you know, area of expertise is. Someone asked, do I go agent? Do I go clients? You know, I say, again, John, you're the expert, not me. But what I love, what as I'm seeing this, and I've gotten to spend time with you as well, is I know this is something you're a knowledge, you're an expert in, you're knowledgeable in, and now you're picking up luxurious Airbnb listings, and you are also a luxury Airbnb host, where you can charge anywhere from, I believe, how much a night for what's her name?
La Casa Alejandrina.
La Casa Alejandrina, which I am low-key excited to stay in. We kind of said, I'm going to stay there. You can stay at my house. I'll stay at your house. But can you tell us a little bit about that and how you said something that you were passionate on? You said, let me incorporate it into YouTube. So this way, you know, again, I'm positioned as that expert. I think it's important for people to know that.
Yes, that's a great point. So one thing with YouTube that I notice is some people will pick a niche and just go all in on it. And what I'll say is, like, just talk about whatever you're passionate about, because it's gonna come more natural. You're gonna be able to go deeper into that topic as well. And what I did with Airbnb, one, I had the experience of running my own Airbnb. I was an Airbnb community leader in Puerto Rico and an ambassador. So, you know, one thing I do is I will coach people on how to create their Airbnb listings on the platform. So I had to know all the ins and outs. So creating a video on something that I work with every day became very natural. And in addition to that, once I established myself kind of like the go-to guy for Airbnb in Puerto Rico, which is another thing to take note, is you can create multiple forms of income from your YouTube channel. So from this, once I was known as the Airbnb guy, I created an ebook that I sold and sold in about, I don't know, like 500 copies or so. From there, I created a service where I can create, you know, if you're starting an Airbnb, I will do consulting. I will visit a property and do consulting on it. I can also create your listing and automize and optimize that listing as well. So you can create multiple forms of income from this alone. Then we've gotten into management as well, partnerships. So, you know, as you start talking about this, if you have that knowledge, that's going to, people will know right away if you dominate that topic or not. So if there's something that you know you're passionate about, but don't be afraid to just make that one. I saw that kind of like as a stepping stone to start looking into other areas. Right now, if you start looking at my the length of my channel over the last year or so, it was very heavy on Airbnb at the beginning. Now that I have already established myself and everybody knows me for Airbnb, you're gonna see that my content has shifted a lot to attract more sellers, right? That's kind of like where I'm trying to go at luxury homes, getting selling leads, and that's how we're moving. So you're gonna see that there's a lot less Airbnb content in the last 4 or 5 months.
And I am sharing your Casa Alejandrina so we can go ahead and get a little bit of promo here. Can you see how this has really opened up not only, like you said, the management, being positioned as the expert, the luxury listing agent, the luxury agent that can showcase a property, all while incorporating his passion for real estate and building his YouTube content. So this property, he named it, he gave it a persona, and she went viral as well. This is one of the most popular Airbnbs on the island. And one of the things that I think was really cool is me and John were talking, was like, it doesn't have to be on the beach. It just has to have beautiful views and, you know, an experience. So he's all about creating an experience in everything that he does. So I just wanted to share that because I was super inspired by your super host and, you know, just the amount of detail and like vision that you put into this property that you got for a great deal. And yes, what's the most a night it'll go for?
$1,200
a night.
Yes.
Low key, guys, this is amazing. Carlos, I think you had some questions as well. You wanted to chime in because you're passionate about YouTube, and we'll just bounce some stuff off.
Yeah, I love this topic because I've been on my own YouTube journey And, you know, one question that somebody asked earlier that I want you to go a little bit deeper on, as far as, you know, your avatar for the channel, and how is, do you stay congruent with that as a realtor? Because as a realtor, we want to do agents. We want to do buyers and sellers. You know, you may want to do renters. I mean, for me, I struggle thinking, should I do content about aging attraction, or should I just add value? And like, if I add something very aging attraction heavy, like teaching how to attract, does it fit within this channel? Or should I have multiple channels? So that's one of the things that I feel a lot of people struggle with. So I was wondering your thoughts on that.
Perfect. That's a good question. So in terms of the avatar, I'm a little bit, I haven't, you know, at first, you know, I went hard on Airbnb and it brought me a lot of results at a smaller scale. Now I'm seeing a larger scale, right? Obviously, as of last week. But what I did was, especially with educational videos, if I'm doing two videos a week, there's no reason why I can't talk to the seller, why I can't talk to the investor and the buyer all in different videos. You know, so the person who's buying, maybe I'm talking to them the difference between an FHA and a USDA rural loan on Tuesday. And on Friday, maybe I'm talking to that investor about flipping and how to calculate their NOI, how to estimate costs, and doing all that. So I think there's space to open up. And what I did was, I did have a team before coming to EXP. So any buyer leads, I will give them to my team. I will share that with my team. I kept the seller leads and pretty much everything with Airbnb, I did it as well. But I think there's opportunity to do everything. You just gotta be mindful of how you're gonna manage that influx of leads. And making sure that you're consistently getting feedback from your audience. And the way you can do that is, so if you will go, for example, you go to my channel today on the community page, where it's where you can do posts, share, do polls, share pictures there. I will poll my audience, you know, what content interests you the more? Are you a buyer? Are you a seller? Are you somebody who's looking to invest? And that will influence my, you know, my timing as to which videos I want to release for that, and maybe tailor my content. So that's one way to do it. In terms of agent retention or agent attraction, which I haven't dealt with that in the past, but it's something that I will definitely start working on. What I'm thinking right now is possibly doing a second channel for agents. It's a different language, it's very specific, so I might do a different channel for that.
God, I love it. Yeah, I like how you position that in the sense of, it's like as if you were HGTV, right? You're your own TV channel. We have different shows. You have one video dropping on Tuesday, one on Thursday, different kind of content. So definitely love how you look at that. Now, if you're going completely off base, like with the agent side of content, then hey, maybe that requires a completely different channel. Were you going to say something, Eli? Go ahead.
Yeah, I actually find it pretty interesting that Veronica started this conversation or your introduction with how much you've dominated and what a big deal you've become in HUD properties, which is foreclosures. It's usually the ugly properties. But then you've also been able to marry that with this harmony of now luxury properties and Airbnbs. How does that happen? Because I think one of the biggest fears out there, just like that, in not saying that first question was out of fear, but it's like, you know, if I want to be in the luxury market, I can't be doing foreclosures for HUD. And if I'm doing foreclosures for HUD, nobody with a luxury property is going to hire me. And you broke that mold. So how does that happen? And how do you think you've been able to balance that? Or do you, is there different platforms, or do you just not put that on your YouTube? Can you help us understand how you've been able to balance that?
Yeah, so in terms of YouTube itself, I don't put like videos of HUD homes or anything like that, because I just don't make it for them, right? The market is very different. It doesn't quite require video to market that type of property. But what I do is I do a lot of education for buyers and for agents on how to manage HUD homes. But I did came up with that kind of problem where I was like, wait, am I getting, you know, in this box too much where I'm just getting associated? And we actually created kind of like a plan as to how to start changing the perception of what type of agent we were. And we started doing this thing where we will look for sale by owners of luxury homes. And we will call them and we'll make an approach and tell them, hey, this is our channeler and this is the tools that we use. We see that you're selling your property. I think you can benefit from getting more exposure. I'm not looking to list it right away. If that happens, you know, in the future that you feel like you can't sell yourself and you want to consider us, that's great. But I think we can create great content for you. We can market it. I see that you're already paying a buyer's agent commission. So this will be for free. We'll just set up the day. We'll do the content. We'll put it on all of our platforms. And what that did was starting to shift the perception of people were starting associating us with these houses in Dorado, in Rio Grande, these big mansions in Palmas del Mar. And by doing that, not with the intention that, the main intention that we were just trying to get that lead, but we're just trying to get the content. And if the lead happens to fall in our lap, then we're perfect. But it will give us that content for us to leverage. So we started doing that. And then outside of YouTube on Instagram, we did the same thing, but just getting the data, what are the properties that are being sold in the market, on the luxury market, and we're just presenting that to the public. And a lot of times the public won't know the difference between who listed it, who sold it. You know, you say these are the top three sales in Puerto Rico from Seller MLS, and you say it was listed by whoever, people won't even read that probably, especially if you put it at the end of your post. So they just think automatically that you're selling or listing all these big properties, and they associate your brand and yourself with these luxury properties.
Great question.
Love that.
I know that you wanted, I know that we showed your YouTube page earlier, and we wanna make sure that anyone that also has a question can come up and ask as well. I think what's really important is like, if they were to start today, what is the very first thing that these agents on here today, the first top three things they should do to get started? And there's a lot of, you know, YouTube University, YouTube formula books, you know, download, you know, buy YouTube University. There's YouTube formula, the secrets to YouTube, you know, but John Gallo, if you were to teach someone today to do this repeatable, what are the top three things they should do?
So the first thing I will say is, there's that first video, right? And then it comes the rest. So that first video, you realize a few things. Nobody's gonna watch it. So it doesn't matter how bad it is, right? And the people that are gonna watch it, they'll probably still find some value on it. Right? So don't be afraid to post that video, but you don't need much. And I think there's a misconception that you need all these things. I still film my my instructional videos with an iPhone and a ring light, right? And I switched that like the last 2 weeks. Now I'm filming on a studio, but before that, the 98 videos I did before that, it's just a ring light, a tripod, and a cheap microphone from Best Buy and an iPhone. And that's all you need, right? And then you just record yourself. And then you use some free software to just cut the beginning, the end. Don't think about it too much. And the thing is to make sure that every day you're looking for one thing to improve, right? Just make sure one day, every video, you look at your videos like, maybe my title could have been better. You know, maybe my thumbnail could have been better. Maybe my description. And if you improve one thing every week, that's 52 improvements in a year. So when you look at that first video, from that number 52, it's gonna be night and day. But if I say just three things to focus on once you start getting on this role of doing videos, I'll highly encourage people to do batch recording and just think of it. Don't think yourself as something additional that you're doing. This is part of your prospecting time, right? But this is contrary to sitting down for 4 hours and doing cold calling. This is 24/7 prospecting. There's people watching video all the time. You go to sleep, there's people watching your video, right? So just think of that as your 4 hours of prospecting that is gonna multiply, you know, over time. So do batch videos where you sit down one day for 3-4 hours and record 4, 5, 6 videos, because that's gonna make it not feel as heavy from the beginning. This, if you get in this role of doing one video every week, then next week you get too busy and you forget to schedule that one video, right? So if you time block that space for filming, that's going to help. I also time block one day for a couple hours where you can get all your ideas and the type of videos that you want to create, right? That's going to be part. So right now what I do is I do time block one day a week, and that one day is every Tuesday. The first Tuesday of the month, I just do a content idea and just kind of like get the layout for what videos I'm going to film. The second week, I do all my educational videos. And now we're starting to do the interviews, and those two other weeks, we'll set up 2 to 3 interviews in those weeks. So on a month, you know, I have about 2 videos per week. I filmed 3 days, and then one day was just my, you know, my brainstorming day where I was coming up with ideas. As soon as you can, try to leverage either your thumbnails. Could be the first thing because it's the cheapest of all. Because, I mean, we're out there to sell houses, we're going to share knowledge, but maybe we're not as creative thumbnails. But there's people in, you know, Philippines, Venezuela, Dominican Republic, they can do it for a very low cost. The same thing for the editor. Right now, I have an editor that charges me $300 for 8 videos per month. That, you know, to me, my time is, you know, it takes me about 8 hours to do half a video because I'm not good at editing. So, you know, batch recording, I start outsourcing some of that. And then number 3, I will say is just be consistent in analyzing your channel for improvement. Like I say, just look at something that quite didn't work or what worked from that last video and see how you can implement it on the next video so you have that continuous improvement week over week.
Hey, Jan, I have one question as far as mindset, because, you know, a lot of people start these channels and then they give up, you know? So what was your mindset along the way? Because I think right now you're in a small percentage of people with 5,000 subscribers. I heard a statistic that I think less than 20% have 1,000 or more in all of YouTube, if not less than that. And that's because a lot of people quit. So how was it like for you starting out? Did you catch a break? I know you struggled, you know, and got burned out, but even beyond that, you know, how did you keep going? Was it that constant improvement mindset and not giving up? Let's give him some mindset, because YouTube is definitely one of those things that you gotta put in the work.
Yes. So I would say that one of the things that kept me going is I had an accountability partner that he was on me all the time, every time, still to this day. So having that accountability partner definitely helps. That's big. And once I got to do the batch recording, that made everything easier. So my mindset was always like, I know I'm going to need YouTube and this is going to be good for me in the long run. How do I do it where it doesn't feel heavy? You know, how can I make it where it doesn't feel heavy? So now for me, it doesn't feel as heavy. It's just part of my weekly routine where I have one day of thinking and 3 days of performing, and then everything else goes out, you know, to the editor to take care of. And that's part of my week. That's just part of my schedule. So if you make it to where it doesn't feel heavy anymore, I think you have a better chance of just having that continuity and that, going and making sure every week you're putting out content.
Love that. Does anyone have a question they want to personally ask John and kind of we put you on the spotlight, and maybe you can share if you're just beginning, or maybe if you're stuck, or if you're having some challenges that you want to run by someone, please like let us know. We want to bring you up. So this way your voice also, your question may help someone else that's thinking about it. We don't think we have all the answers or the right questions all the time. We know that you guys are the ones who really or who we want to serve. So if anybody has a question, let us know, raise your hand, and we'll bring you to the spotlight, because this is for you guys. We want you to decide today to take action on this and say, you know, you heard him. He needed an accountability buddy. You know, maybe you guys amongst each other today can decide who's going to be that accountability buddy for you. So I see some chats coming up. All right, Edis. All right, let's get Edie's Let's just bring you up, girlfriend. You're asking a great question. Where are you at? ¿Dónde está Iris? Iris, let me hear your voice. No te veo. Where you at, girl?
I'm here.
Oh, there you go. I don't see your face, but I hear your voice. We're going to pin you anyways. Cuéntame. What you got?
I'm not in the best dress mode.
That YouTube video question. Will go viral right there. That's the one we got to put up, girlfriend. Just be you. I love it.
Quick question. So the majority of my clients, I will say about 85 to 90% of my clients are Spanish-speaking people. Do I make videos just in English or Spanish, being that the majority of them are Spanish-speaking?
Great question.
Yes. I will say the majority of them are Spanish-speaking. I will talk directly to them if that's your target audience and you know where you're getting released from. So I will speak in Spanish and I will just add, you know, that I'll just encourage people to add subtitles or just add the English subtitles, you know, for the, if you have a big spread, you know, let's say you have like a 90-10 with 90 Spanish speaking, 10% is.
Oh, really?
You can get most of your deals from that 90%. So I will do it in Spanish. Yeah. And just have the subtitles in there, which are automatically available pretty much in YouTube right now.
Love it. So I hope that answers her question. Look, if your niche is in Spanish and your clients are in Spanish.
Can I make a comment on this? I love this question. Okay, so when I started my TikTok, for example, all my content was in English, all my content. And I think I made it to like 1,000 subscribers, 1,000 followers and whatnot. And the Spanish speaking market is super underserved. When I switched to doing content in Spanish, I'm at 44,000 followers. We got several leads, listings, buyers out of it. It is so underserved that I would actually focus, it's not even a question to me, just focus on Spanish, because it is a very underserved community. Like, we just are underrepresented, I think would be the better question out there, because all of us here who are Hispanics are focusing on English. And when you make that shift to Spanish, you do create a new niche. And maybe in English, I could have 100,000 subscribers, but the 44,000 that I have that are mostly Spanish speakers are actually bringing me business, because it's more about the quality than the quantity for me.
Love that. I hope that answered not only those who might also be thinking, should you do it in Spanish if you are serving your community, but think of the community that you're serving. Think of the community that you're serving, whether it's in English, Spanish, whatever language, speak the language of your clients. And even if it's in English, just speak the language that you are, you know, you are used to speaking, whether it's community, whether it's luxury, whether it's Airbnbs, whether it's, you know, again, what you're looking to serve. So I love that. Thank you, Eli. I appreciate it. And if you're not following Eli's TikTok game, guys, you guys definitely need to, because he is amazing. We're super proud. Evelyn has a question. Let's get Evelyn up here. Hey, girl.
Yes. Hi, Veronica. Hi, guys. Thank you, Yan and Eli. This is fabulous content. So talking about languages, I've tried something and I was kind of surprised. So my first language is French and my second language is English. So I usually do my videos in English. I live in California. But then I realized it's not that much energy for me after I record it in English to do it in French. Right. So then having like same content in both languages, the funny thing is people that only speak French will listen to both, and people that only speak English love understanding the English version, but still they want to hear it in French because it's just something different. So I think all of us here that speak two languages, it's really an edge and can be really charming too. So I just encourage like doing videos in two different languages.
Awesome. Love that, Evelyn. Thank you so much. And if you guys don't know Evelyn, she's out of California, but is also Canadian and has a really big influence in Canada as well. Guys, we're global. We're going global here. So don't forget the amazing people we have here for referrals. Look no further. Right in this community, we can help serve each other at the highest level. Great comment. Thank you guys so much. We try to keep this, you know, within the integrity of the time. If there's anyone else that has a question, we'd like to get you up on here.
Before they start heading out of here, think of your question, guys. So, you know, we have some minutes, but hey, this is YouTube week. Not only do we have this session of Gap Mastermind devoted to YouTube, but on Wednesday, We have another massive YouTube influencer coming to share his experience, his knowledge, his skills with us at the Global Alliance during the Global Alliance Mastermind. The Global Alliance Mastermind happens once a month, and we bring you the top influencers from EXP, the alphas. And we have Mike Sherrar coming on this Wednesday at 7:30. He's approaching about 100,000 subscribers on YouTube, and he's going to be talking about how to get buyers, sellers, and agent attraction. So going into this topic from another person that's doing amazingly well out there. So you do not want to miss that. We're also promoting Build 23, the Build Conference. We have exclusive chat where we're adding everybody there. So if you're going to Build, to the Build Conference in San Antonio, Texas, coming up next month, let us know so we can add you to that chat. Let's have a community together. Or if you needed a reminder, a small nudge that you need to be there hanging out with us, spending time with us, learning, growing. Big things happen at big events. You can sit down and share rice and beans with Eli and Jan, like I did at Shareholders. You know, we hung out. What was that place called? I completely forgot, but it was awesome.
Melau.
Hey, Melau restaurant, guys. You could have been there, but you didn't go to Shareholders. So we want to share some rice and beans with you over at Build. So don't miss it. And just magic happens at these events. Those are two big things that I just wanted to drop there. And who's going to take the last question, guys? Who's going to take the last comment?
Yeah, and I want to, real quick, while that person raises their hand, I want to echo Mike Sherrard has become a really great friend of ours. The collaboration amongst different leaders in the company is so special. I mean, I think I bought his course. He set us up for our backend solutions for onboarding, you know, and he is right now the number one followed agent on YouTube. So there's a lot to learn from him. Don't miss it, guys. And for those of you who miss Shareholders, like Carlos said, especially some of you guys who are in our backyard, my heart hurt for you because you missed out on some really special things, but don't miss Build and make sure you're here this week. I'll echo that. Mike is there's a reason why he's the number one FLQA grower in the company, with over 300 plus agents, and teaching agents not only how to build their business through lead generation, but also agent attraction. So make sure you don't miss it. Okay, so we have Barbara as the question. I'm going to go ahead and unpin myself and allow her to step up and ask the question.
Me, Barbara? I don't know if there's other Barbara. Barbara's on. Okay, how are you guys? I miss you.
So good to see you.
Great. Yeah, great class as always. So I know we said we're going to get to some AI, how to get this all started. I don't know if we got to it. I think I took one note on that. So any particular ones I need to like research today to get started in YouTube for, you know, content creation, editing, and all that stuff?
Yes, I will tell you, we don't have enough time to share, but BidIQ, which is B-I-D-I-Q, BidIQ, search that one. That's a plugin that goes directly into your YouTube channel, and it will analyze everything on your channel, and it will give you also give you ideas, AI generated thumbnails, AI generated tags, and now they recently launched an AI kind of like a ChatGPT, but it's real time for your channel, so you can tell them, can you please analyze my channel and tell me how can I modify my content to reach a luxury sellers in Lake Nona, for example. And it will tell you, about your titles, it will tell you what content to do, it will tell you about your call to actions, whether they need to improve or not. So it's really good. It will also give you keywords and key phrases that you can look up, and it will tell you, for example, if you look for living in, it will tell you that it's a highly searched term. Right. And if you look, for example, live in Texas, it will tell you there's a lot of content creation done in Texas for that tag. But if you look for live in Lake Nona, you will find out that it's a great target. So just look for those keywords, which one work for your market. For example, coffee shops in Orlando. That may be something that people are looking for a lot and they're not finding. And it may be that in New York, somebody does it. If I do it in San Juan, it's not going to get many views because I have a lot of competition. But if I do it in Lake Nona, I know that it's going to be a great search term. So there's that I would say is the most powerful tool that I've used there's a lot of other editing software, AI driven, but in terms of your channel, extracting the, you know, the most out of it and getting the these recommendations, that's definitely the best one that I use.
Thank you. And I think you said you had a little tip sheet that you created. I don't know how we can, you know, hijack that little tip sheet, but whatever you got, John, bring it to the arsenal. We'll make sure.
I'll pass it to Jenny. Really what it was is I added some content creators that will expedite your learning for simple things like doing simple lighting for your set, what microphones are the best, what thumbnails work, stuff like that. And then just talk about VidIQ and all their AI tools. And I'll put that all on the sheet and I'll send it to Jenny and maybe she can distribute it out to the people that signed up today.
We 100% will make sure everyone gets it. Not only those who are here, but our Global Alliance family for our resource library. And that's what this is all about. So I'm super grateful. Don't forget again about Wednesday, 7:30. Carlos, I believe the link is globalalliance.com.
AllianceLive.com, guys. 7:30, Wednesday.
GlobalAllianceLive.com to learn more about YouTube with the one and only Mike Sherrard. And can we show some love with the fire emoji to Giancarlo Morales from Puerto Rico, but obviously a leader in this space that's going to be beyond the island and someone that we are honored to call our newest partner and leader, who I know is going to continue to pour into this community and grow his business in a massive way. We are cheering you on, Giancarlo. We appreciate you. We appreciate your leadership. Thank you for serving our country as well and for being such an amazing leader and believing in what we're building here together. And we're only getting better because of leaders like you who come. Thank you, Eli, Carlos, and everyone who stepped up to ask the question, and everybody who helps run this behind the scenes. I've missed seeing you guys in all of your faces, and I am honored to just call you guys all partners. Have an amazing week. Thank you for making Gap Mastermind so special and our partnership here. Have an amazing week. Bye, guys.